And cut.
What's up, Bulldogs? Welcome back to another episode of PNN.
Coming up next, you'll hear the unique story behind a Portola student's family-owned restaurant, explore teachers' school bag necessities with Mrs. Newton and Ms. Gramier, catch up on our sports updates, and finish off with our most recent episode of Life.
But before we get started, let's go over our latest announcements.
As of right now, we're currently in the midst of finishing AP exams with only 2 days left.
Yeah, and some Bulldogs are even testing as we speak.
So Jonathan, how's it been going for you so far?
Well, it's definitely been a little tough, but I'm getting through it.
That's good. Well, for those of you with your last AP exams coming up this week, or to anyone preparing for finals, we remind you to finish strong in this last stretch of the school year.
And there's something to look forward to as we round the corner.
What's that?
Well, it's Porchella. It's this Friday, so make sure to celebrate by joining in and supporting our fellow musicians.
On that note, we should also mention the instrumental concert being held the week after on Thursday, May 23rd. We can't wait to connect with our Portola community and hear our talented Bulldogs perform.
Speaking of community, this next piece explores the story behind a welcoming restaurant where some of our very own Portola staff and students have performed.
While many Portola students have experience in working in the food and service industry, one Portola student has fostered an even deeper connection.
I grew up here. Like every few days I come here, I learned how to cut a fish when I was like 8.
Luke has been coming to Brew Grill and Market for years since he was a kid. Its name is inspired by his late grandfather and is owned by his parents.
We've owned it for 13 years now. I can't believe it.
Although Luke only officially started working at Brew a little over a year ago, it still holds some of his father's childhood memories.
Like, it's kind of like a sense of home, because we've moved like several times over the past few years, but we've always had this restaurant and this place to come back to with our family and celebrate things.
We won top 250 restaurants in America. We won best of OC several years in a row. We've won several awards for individual items. So, it's going well, it's going well.
But despite Brew's momentous success, the Panic family's journey came with its own serving of hurdles.
So in total, I've had 9 heart attacks, which is crazy. My heart is got congestive heart failure, so it's not great. But I've had 2 of those heart attacks here in the restaurant. It's just a challenge. But the amazing thing about our family is when anything happens, or if I need a day off, or you know something drastic like that happens, they all just rally, and the team rallies too, and they all step up and cover everything.
So when my dad was sick, my mom would be here like every single day. Like especially when I was younger, seeing my mom have to work so much and stuff, it really made me want to help the family and do anything I could.
That part's pretty amazing. And we have guests, you know, calling us in the hospital asking how can we help, what can we do, and so it's just nice, but doing better today.
Despite their struggles, it was the vibrant community at Brew that reminded them of their purpose.
I mean, my favorite part is the people, and that's really the only reason why you get into this business is if you love hospitality and that's in your heart, you love serving people. Building a team, we have a team of about 65 people here that work together to make this all happen. And they're all like family to us. The main thing to me is if you can change someone's day, someone walks in the door and they're either having a great day or they may have had a bad day and you don't know what happened, you know, they may have lost someone or, but if you can do something to make their day better and have them leave on a positive experience or have a great memory, then that's pretty special.
Today, it's undeniable that Brew's community has grown substantially. In fact, it's even reached as far as Portola.
So last month, we had Mr. Traska and a few other jazz teachers from IUSC come here, but that turned out to be our busiest brunch in years. We even have some teachers who come here, just random days I'll see them. It really builds a sense of community. It shows how small the world is. It's cool.
And serving the community is what has made Luke and his family who they are today.
I just really hope that people can kind of understand what service is and how much it can teach you. Like, I have several friends who are working in places like In-N-Out or Chick-fil-A, and it really changes how you see the world, and it gives you respect and a work ethic that prepares you for your life in the future.
And if your goal is to, you know, come in and make money and earn tips and go home, then that's probably not the right mindset for us. But if you come in with a heart of hospitality and you want to help people and you want to make people's days better, then all those things and those rewards come to you 1,000 times over.
It's amazing to see the amount of work and dedication it takes to run a restaurant. Thank you, Luke, for sharing your family story.
I know another thing that takes a lot of work and dedication.
Which is?
Sports. Let's hear our latest updates. Take it away, Ennes.
I said you need me now. I said you need me now. You need me. Stick to the code, binary like eyes and nose. I'm too exposed, I gotta keep curtains closed. Her body bold, she hid it behind the clothes. I'm in Cabo, I'm hitting his adios. Trying to balance all these up and downs, but I keep popping lows. Man, it is what it is, that's just how it goes. Period session, I just kept progressing, finally found the flow. If the answer's down there with the devil, I may never know. My dog just got freed out the precinct. Hit it in my bag, let's hit Turks for the weekend. Why did I pop two out of that whole pack, dog? I'm tweaking. She gon' let me be.
What's up, everyone? I'm Ennes, and welcome back to another episode of PNN Sports. First up, let's congratulate our student athletes who have made their college commitments. Ryder Cooper is set to take his skills to Cal State Fullerton for Division I track and field. Emelina Ellison is headed to Wellesley College for girls basketball, and Ellie Wolf is also headed to Wellesley for track and field. Joining them, we have Trey Mraz committing to Southern Virginia University for cross country and track, Davis Gursky to Lake Forest College for football, and Luke Porter to the United States Naval Academy for Division I water polo. Congratulations to these outstanding individuals on their exciting futures. For track and field, CIF finalists include Ryder Cooper, Cameron Jeromey, Jason Liu, Michael Hood, Blaze Williams, Abby Richard, and Charisma Agbor. Our girls varsity track team clinched back-to-back league championship titles, and our boys varsity team has secured their third consecutive league championship. Let's give a special shout out to Ryder Cooper, who has been crowned the track MVP, and Taylor Strickland, who has dominated as the field MVP. Finally, our boys swim team has emerged as the Pacific Coast League champions, and with an impressive 13 players from the boys and girls teams qualifying for the state championships, they're ready to make a splash on the big stage. Well, that's it for this week's updates on PNN Sports. Now, I'll pass it back to Shifa and Jonathan.
Thanks, Ennes.
Hey, Jonathan, what do you usually bring to school in your backpack every day?
Oh, you know, none other than my stuffed teddy bear.
Okay. Well, for the rest of us, we usually take the necessities to school. You know, a computer, some notebooks, folders, and things like that. But I'm curious as to what our teachers bring to school every day.
Today, we invited two teachers to share with us what essential items they bring to school every day. Let's take a look.
Hi, I'm Miss Newton, and I teach science here at Portola.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Gramier. I teach Honors American History, and Advanced Journalism. Today, I am going through my work bag to show you what kinds of things I come to school with on a daily basis.
See what we have today. Lots of liquids. Protein smoothie for breakfast. This is what I normally bring my coffee in before it goes into my animal mug. And then my water for the day, the electrolytes.
This is, I guess, one of my most important things for work. This is my clipboard folder, and this is usually where I put any like things I'm grading or things that I have to do that are hard copy.
See, snacks, important. Yum, healthy. Got a hair clip, you never know. Nice little pocket up here, sunscreen.
Hairbrush. And let's see, what else do I have in here? Oh, I have all of my other folders. I'm definitely someone that firmly believes that you need a folder for everything. However, I don't actually end up using any of them. If you notice that only the first couple of pages will be filled out in every folder I have in my bag because I lose interest.
Sunglasses, because you know, you never know. Never know. Got my AirPods. Lots of hair ties. Oh, and a binder clip. Never go anywhere without a binder clip.
makeup, hand cream.
My dog's poop bag. Never know when you need that. Those are everywhere in my house. And lotion. These are my things.
My favorite item is never something that I actually mean to bring with me, but usually because my bag sits on the floor by the door, my two-year-old likes to leave random presents in the bag for me that I end up fighting. So today, he has left for me a bunch of small cars.
Favorite item out of all these? Probably snacks. Today, not that exciting, but sometimes I bring some more fun things. And like liquids. You need liquids. Hydration. Yeah.
Thanks for sharing. One day I hope to be as hydrated as Miss Newton.
Now, let's hear from some of our staff and students as we finish off with Life.
Hey Bulldogs, welcome to another episode of Life with Andrea. Being students, we all have very different schedules, but one thing we do have in common is our teachers. So today I'm going to be going around campus and interviewing some of your favorite teachers. Let's learn a little bit more about these people that make up a key part of our school. Can you introduce yourself for the students that may not know?
Yeah, I'm Mr. Miller. I teach ceramics and photography.
And can you tell me what one of your favorite memories you've had with a student?
A lot of students at the end of the year will write really nice messages, and I've got inside one of my cabinets, I have a whole wall of all my favorite letters that students have written throughout the years, so I really value those nice messages they've done.
It's really sweet. And my final question is, what is one thing you're going to miss from the 2023-24 school year?
I'll be honest, this is the best, collectively the best year for students I've had. Just every class is awesome, engaged, and so just roll the dice every year and hope that next year's is good, but I'm really enjoying this year, so I'm gonna miss everybody.
Oh, this is sweet. Okay, thanks for letting me interview. I'll let you get back to your... No, I'm good. Can you introduce yourself?
I'm Madam Kirby.
Can you tell me why did you decide to teach French at Portola?
I decided to teach because I love learning languages, and so as I was learning a language, I thought, how could I make this an easier process for someone who hasn't had the experience of learning a language? And then I just really like working with the high school age group. You are all so funny and most of the time responsible, but also resilient, and it's just, it's a super fun like age range in life, so I like working with high schoolers.
Hi, my name is Mr. Lopez, and I teach Spanish here at Portola High School.
Very nice. Can you tell me, why did you become a teacher or decide to become one?
I became a teacher because I had a really good high school experience, and I wanted to have that experience or provide that experience for the students here as well. I also wanted to help students and help them achieve their goals and dreams.
Okay, what's one slang term or phrase that you learned from your students?
I learned to use ate.
Give me an example of a sentence.
Yes, like, she ate, like she did that really well.
Do you think your students eat in the present tense? Do they eat in your Spanish classes?
Oh, they do eat.
Okay, good. I hope so. It was so much fun being able to interview these teachers and hear a little bit more about all of the hard work that they do. Remember to give thanks to your teachers, and if you enjoyed today's episode of Life, stay tuned to the next episode of Life with Andrea.
Well, that wraps up this week's episode, and it's crazy to see how this is our second to last episode of the year. This school year has truly sped right by yet again.
Before we go, I want to take a moment to acknowledge the honor I've had of reporting for season 7 of PNN. And I want to thank you all for watching, as this is my last episode of this school year. I wish you all the best and hope you have an amazing summer.
And don't forget to stay tuned for our season 7 finale featuring a special end of the year senior episode. I'll see you then
on PNN.